One of the most powerful and underrated tools inside of Lightroom and Camera Raw is the adjustment brush. Most people just use a tiny little bit of the features, but it's amazing what you can do with this brush, and it's got some really powerful features in it. Right now, we're going to start with the very basics and go through and cover every feature inside of the adjustment brush. By the end of this video, you're going to understand the brush in a way you never have before, and this is just going to give you so much power to edit your images exactly how you want. So here we are in Adobe Bridge, which comes with Photoshop. What we want to do is find the image. This is an ARW, which is a Sony RAW file. We're going to right-click, and we're going to choose to open in Camera Raw. Now, this is a visual way to do it. If you're in Photoshop and you choose File Open and it's a RAW file, it will also open here into Camera Raw and it will skip the Photoshop interface initially. Great. All right, so what we want to do is use the brush tool to specify where we want to make our adjustments. So if we go under the mask tool, you'll see all the mask options are here and this is the brush. This is how you get to the brush. So we're going to click on the brush now. And we've got a brand new mask with a brush. Let me show you how it works. With the brush, you paint, and then it applies a mask to the area you've painted. At that point, you can go down and you can use it to lighten or darken, or make any number of adjustments to that brush. The nice thing is, once we have already created it, if I continue to paint, notice now I'm painting with this brightening brush. See that? And we're lightening up those areas. So you can adjust it later. Notice all those areas are now going to be adjusted. And as you could see, as you're painting, you can see that. Now, if you wanted to prefer, keep it with the mask, keep overlay on. And as you paint, it's just going to paint with that mask overlay. And then when you hide that overlay, you can apply your adjustments. All right. What I'm going to do is I'm going to reset all the masks. And let's have a look here. We're going to create it once again. We're going to go to the brush. And let's look at some of the features in the brush. Now, if I want to change the size or the hardness, we can do that. Let me just tap once to apply the brush. And let's look at the brush settings here. So here's our brush settings. We can change the size by dragging left or right. And that will make it larger or smaller. Problem with that, notice we don't see it on the image. It's hard to match maybe that point that we added. If I use a left bracket key, I can make it smaller. Right bracket key will make it bigger. So let's paint over this area. Notice it's not a very good job of painting the edge. If I turn on auto mask and I paint, notice now it will detect the edge and it makes it easier to stay within the lines. We'll turn the auto mask off again for the texture areas in between. All right, so what if we went too far and we want to clean some of this up? There's two ways to do it. One is if you hold down the Alt or the Option key, notice you see that it becomes a minus. And notice as I hit that too, notice that the panel will change. Another thing you'll see, it pops into this eraser. So I can get the same thing by tapping on the eraser. Now we're in minus. And if I wanted to clean up the edge, we can also choose auto mask here and use that auto mask to help me clean up that edge. So that's quite useful. All right, another thing you might have noticed, if I go in here, notice it's quite harsh. Let's turn the auto mask off. We get a hard edge. So the feather can change that. If we feather, we get a soft edge. And it makes it easier to blend things in. Notice too that it's not going all the way. If I take flow and turn flow all the way up, it will just automatically go very, very quickly. Whereas if I turn the flow down, it will gradually build it up. But sometimes that's how you want to work with the eraser. Okay, and notice that feather is changing. Let me go back to the brush so you can see this. So if I paint here, take the feather down, it's there. Once again, you can't see it on the image. But if you hold down the shift key and hit the left and right bracket keys, you can adjust the feather with the keyboard on screen and you can see what's going on. Great. Now, if I want to access that eraser, once again, hold down the Alt or the Option key. Notice that it remembered the last settings. So whatever I set there in the eraser tool is going to be remembered. When I let go, the brush settings are going to be persistent. So let's hold down the Alt or the Option key. Let's turn flow all the way up, release. Notice if I do that, now it's all the way up. So we can very quickly go in there and go between the two. So the Alt or the Option will toggle. If you're working inside the eraser and you hit Alt or Option, you can toggle to the brush. So this is useful. It lets you set up a different setting for your brush and for your eraser, and you can work with the two together to refine your selections. All right. So once we've made that selection, let's just go back to the brush. There's two other settings here, flow and density. So right now, if I paint, notice I'm just getting the entire mask right there. If I turn the flow down quite low, notice, or even lower, notice we can get there, but it takes a little bit more time. So this slowly builds up, kind of like an airbrush, if you've ever seen an airbrush. If not, like a spray paint, you know, when you spray with a can. The more you go, the more it builds up. So you can slowly work, and this is great for doing things like shading and different things like that. If we turn that flow up, it'll go up faster. All the way up, there's no fading, it just starts right away. Density is different. Density is what is the target. Flow, how fast do we get there? Density, if I've got this at 50, now it's going to paint a mask that's going to be 50%. You might not see it right now till we make some adjustments. Let's make some adjustments. So I'm going to take the exposure. Let's take it all the way up. There we go. Great. All right. So now if we're painting, let's go to that brush setting. And if we look at this, the density is quite high. Let's take the density down. Now if I paint, notice it'll adjust a bit less. So the interesting thing about the density is if I paint over an area that's already been, it will actually take it back to that density level. So this is something that Photoshop does not do. So if I set that to 14, this is going to be a 14% density. If I want to make it more dense, notice I paint over it. And I know it's brightening because that's what we set that to. So we're painting with a very bright brush. So that bright brush is changing. If we bring the density down, that target density is going to be lower, which is nice because now we can, you know, get very, very even by doing that. Turn the density up higher, more of it. Now, with the lower density, if I paint over it, it changes. But if I paint again, it doesn't add to it. The brush in Photoshop, as you paint over and over, it will add, but not here in Camera Raw. So we're just setting everything to that 49% density. Great. All right, so why don't we just reset that right now? And let's go ahead now that you kind of have an idea of what the brushes do. Let's go ahead and do some work with them. All right, so we're going to go to the mask and we're going to choose a brush. I want to brighten up this area. It's way too dark. So let's make it a little bit bigger and start to paint around here. All right, great. But I want to get to the edges. I don't want to go over. So I'm going to turn the auto mask on and I'm going to paint up to those edges there. Now here, it might be a bit more difficult in the mountains to use that auto mask. It will stop it going into the sky. But let's, you know, get a little bit of blending here and let's see what we can do. Let's make the adjustments. So if we choose the shadows, notice this will open up the shadows just in that area. And we can do the exposure. I mean, you could go all the way up to make it really bright, but you don't want to do that. You want to keep it a little bit natural. So all we're trying to do is just open up some of this without it appearing, you know, artificial. Because this is the beginning. Let's get some more of that detail. Great. And maybe these mountains you want to do a little bit more. So another way we can do that is we just create a new mask and we're going to add another brush. And we're just going to paint into this area here. And we're going to do the same thing. let's just take the shadows and brighten up those darker parts of those shadows, hit the exposure a little bit. It's getting a little too bright there, so let's bring the highlights back to protect those brighter areas. And you can see what we're doing now. We're seeing a little bit more detail. Now, if you wanted to blend this or feather this off, what we're going to do is hit the minus key. We covered this already, and we want that feather all the way up so it's nice and soft. But we're going to bring the flow down so we can slowly blend this. Look at this. If the flow was too high, it would make that abrupt edge. But what we want to do is just feather that or blend it. So by turning that flow down, we can kind of do that. And then we don't get a harsh edge. It's more of a natural kind of a blend. Maybe we want to darken some of this. So we're going to create another mask. So create mask, brush. And we're going to paint in here. Now, sometimes you don't have to be that precise when you're painting, by the way, if you're doing subtle adjustments. Let's see how this looks. If we take this and we're going to pull the highlights back a little bit, look at that. Exposure just a touch. Yeah, see, that's working quite nicely. If we wanted to do the pier, let's add another. And we can go in here and let's just paint over the whole thing. Now, notice what I'm doing here. We're painting over there. And if you notice on the brush settings, let's bring those up. We have the auto mask on. Why does that matter? Well, let me show you something. Let's take exposure all the way up or all the way down. See, these pieces have all been missed. That's because it's trying to mask those details in there. So if we go in and we turned that option off, let me show you. Auto mask off. Notice we can easily fill that in, but it goes over the edges. But I hinted at that earlier. Sometimes you just, this is what I would do actually. Let's get rid of just this one mask and I'll show you a better way of doing it. So let's click here. We're going to delete that mask. Okay, so the best way to do that is we're going to create that new mask with the brush. We want auto mask off because we want to select the middle. So let's just go in here. So we know we're getting a good selection in the middle there, but don't go too close to the edges just yet. This is going to give us a good solid selection. Now we're going to turn those options on, auto mask. Make the brush a little bit smaller and let's go there, right up to the edge. Now, one of the things you notice, I messed it up here. Let me show you why. That circle, see that inner circle needs to stay. If that inner circle goes over, see how it starts to spread? Well, in this case, it just did anyway. That's fine. So try to keep that inner circle, though, within the shape. And in the outer circle, most of the time will behave itself. In this situation, it didn't. Let's have a look, turn the overlay off. Yeah, I can see why. I was struggling to see the edge there because it's kind of similar tones. So in that case, no problem. You know what we're going to do? We're going to hit the, turn that overlay back on. We're going to hit the inverse by hitting Alt or Option, turn auto mask on, and then we're just going to try and get these edges. But let's make sure that we turn the flow all the way up. Let's take that feather down a little bit. And let's also change the size. Great. Now we could probably go in here. There we go. Look at that. And we can fix that edge. All right. Let's go ahead. Notice it's still not perfect. I mean, we could just go with the brush. Go really small brush here. And just manually just be very, very careful with that auto mask on. But just be careful this time. There. Look at that. That works. All right, so now we can make adjustments just on that area. So let's hit the exposure. Maybe we want to make it a little bit brighter, but not too bright. Let's recover the highlights. So all that's doing is just making the very, very bright parts a little bit darker to make them easier to see. Not much is going to happen there. Same thing with the shadows here. We're taking the darkest areas, making them a little brighter. Let's grab the blacks, take it down to the very, very dark areas. Now are going to be dark. Now, it might seem counterproductive doing that with the shadows and the blacks, but the blacks are darker than the shadows. So we want the dark darks, or the blacks, to be strong. But the shadows are kind of like the darker midtones. So it's not quite the same region. Just like the whites are the brightest, brightest part of the image. And sometimes you want to increase it to, you know, get rid of any milkiness that might be there. And then we can see we've done that. Now, if you want to adjust the whole image together after this, choose the edit. Now we jump out of the masks, and any adjustment is going to affect the whole image. So this is great for when we do things like color temperature, because you want to move this together so that it doesn't look like different pieces, but it looks like the one image. We're looking pretty good. So let me know in the comments if you learned anything new about the adjustment brush in this tutorial. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you're looking for another tutorial, check out this one right here. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.